Hello, it's Cry here, and I'm bringing you the most comprehensive Sacred Seals guide on the internet to help you optimize your build. There are only 9 Sacred Seals in-game, and unlike Lindstone staffs, there aren't options like Lusats or Azures to help boost your Sacred Seal damage through more FP consumption. Even then, there's a ton of new ones to consider for Sacred Seals, so you might get lost without the explanations if you jump to the summary. Just a heads up. I will be going through faith scaling at 60, 70, 80, and 99 faith, and because none of the sacred seals have a high faith requirement, I will also be briefly covering 50 faith, which is a good point for hybrid builds. Of course, I won't forget the sacred seals that scale to other stats. Let's get started with 60 faith, the first soft cap. The spell buff column is the most important column. This is how much incantation scaling you're getting out of your seal. First, you will notice that the finger seal is weaker than the Godslayer seal. In fact, it will always be weaker than at least one other seal even if you go higher, as we will see later, or even if we drop low to 50 faith. This is the brief mention of the 50 faith slide, by the way. It isn't much different from the 60 faith, but if you want an idea, here it is. Anyways, finger seal is eliminated from the competition. You'll never be using this one for endgame, so there are only 8 more seals left to consider. Moving on to 70 faith, the Earth Tree seal beats out the Godslayer seal as the general raw damage seal by a bit. In fact, it only starts beating Godslayer seal at 69 faith, in case you're wondering about the specific breakpoint. Earth Tree seal has a really weird scaling, as you will see later. As for 80 faith, you can see the lead of Earth Tree seal widening. It has 7.3% more incantation scaling than Godslayer seal now. This is your best seal at 80 faith if you're playing a pure faith build. And if we take a look at 99 faith, her tree seal actually grows relatively weaker. I did mention it has a weird scaling, didn't I? It actually only has 3.3% more incantation scaling over the Godslayer seal at 99 faith. When I do a breakdown of seals plus damage bonuses from the passives later, you will see a clearer picture of its weird scaling in relation to other seals. Alright, sacred seals can be tricky because many of them scale to other stats or have bonuses that push them to being usable. First up is the Clawmark Seal that scales equally well to strength and faith. As you can see, here with the same level of stat investment, it underperforms by a wide margin when compared to raw faith seals. In fact, it is 18.2% and 20.9% weaker than the best general use case seal at the given faith levels. This is quite the wide margin, to the point that if a caster wants to main bestial incantations, which is the bonus Clawmark Seal gives, they're better off not using Clawmark Seal and using Godslayer or Earth Tree, depending on the level instead. Now, you can still run Clawmark Seal on builds that have a lot of strength and little faith. Also, when a weapon has dual attribute scaling, like a fire or lightning scaling for example, the scaling of the weapon changes and the soft cap hits very hard at 50 points. So if you're playing a hybrid strength faith build, Clawmark Seal can be your best bet. If you're doing so, you should thank the stars that one of the best, if not the best incantation in PvP right now, the Bestial Sling, is a bestial incantation, so you at least get some bonus. I also want to point out that you should keep in mind the flame and sacred scaling options, because if you find yourself relying on incantations a lot more than your weapon attack, you might want to consider these scaling over the fire or lightning scaling instead. This way, you can dump more points into faith to make your incantation stronger instead of going for a split between strength and faith. Your weapon damage will probably be lower depending on your stats, but you will do a lot better with your incantations and a pure faith seal. On another note, it is reported on the wiki that the strength portion of this seal does not help with the buff type incantations, making it even weaker since plenty of incantations are buffs. For anyone who wants to dual wield seals in order to get the Clawmark Seal's bestial incantation bonus from the offhand, I suggest mainhanding Syncodia instead. This dagger on your main hand allows you to do better physical attacks, while also granting you the quick step Ash of War. It also boosts bestial incantations by 10% like the Clawmark Seal. It's a little secret weapon for my bestial incantation lovers. On a quick note, if you're finding this video useful so far, please consider liking and subscribing. Next, the Golden Order seal scales equally well to faith and intelligence. As you can see, it is only slightly weaker than the pure faith seals, One good combo to run with this seal is the Sword of Night and Flame. It also plays well with the Golden Order incantations, which gets a multiplier from this seal. At 99 faith, the Erdtree seal has 367 scaling. To match this, you will need 80 points in faith and 49 points in intelligence for Golden Order seal to become the highest scaling seal at endgame, mostly for the purpose of PvE. Your intelligence plus faith needs to be over 128, so this isn't very feasible for meta PvP levels. Something interesting is the Prince of Death only exceeds its counterpart, the Karen Regal Staff, when you have 144 points invested in intelligence and faith combined, which is a whole 16 points more than the Golden Order seal. The Frenzied Flame seal is probably the weirdest scaling item in game, scaling with 4 different attributes, faith a bit better than the other 3. However, it scales completely crap. As you can see here, with 45 points into strength, dexterity, and intelligence, and 99 points into faith, it still underperforms by a wide margin. In fact, even if you max out all your stats, the Frenzy Flame Seal will never be the best seal. You can still offhand it for the passive, and it is still possible to use this in builds where you have little faith and a lot of its other scaling stats though. The Dragon Communion Seal is going to turn a lot of knowledge upside down. It is a sacred seal that scales better to arcane than faith. In fact, it scales so well that at low levels of investment, it actually beats out the pure faith seals. Incantations are for faith, you say? Elden Ring disagrees. The Dragon Communion seal is overpowered at lower levels of investment. Usually, as a hybrid, you would need to give up something in order to gain more access to a wider range of tools. But here, you can play incantations while building arcane. While at around 80 faith power level, the Dragon Communion Seal only slightly loses to the Erdtree Seal in terms of damage. However, in addition to increasing damage, Arcane increases buildup for Bleed, Poison, and Madness, so you double dip into its effectiveness, because Faith only increases damage. Here is a clip from Reddit showcasing Madness Chain CC because Dragon Communion Seal boosts Madness buildup. It is pretty broken right now, and honestly shouldn't work this way, especially combined with status applying even when dodged. This seal plays Madness Incantations better than Frenzy Flame Seal does. So a good question you are probably asking is, when does the Dragon Communion Seal finally lose out to Faith Scaling Seals? The answer is at 74th Faith Investment levels, so quite near the second soft cap of 80. Keep in mind this seal also has a 15% bonus to Dragon Communion Incantations. Because the seal scales to 2 stats, it soft caps at 45 for both Faith and Arcane. Since it scales Arcane better than Faith, the way to maximize your Dragon Communion seal's damage is to upgrade Arcane to 45, Faith to 45, then Arcane to 99, and then Faith to 99. Okay, I'm going to cover your last few options together. The Gravel Stone seal, which boosts Dragon Cult Incantations by 15%. The Giant Seal, which boosts Fire Giant Incantations and Sunfire Monk Incantations by 20%, and the Godslayer Seal, which boosts Godslayer Incantations by 10%. The Godslayer is included here because it loses out to the Erdtree at higher faith, so we're checking if it's still a good option for a specific build. The good news is all these seals have quite a few incantations to work with. Here's a chart I made for the different faith levels. Godslayer is the highest faith scaling seal in the first two instances, so there is one less seal to consider at 50 and 60 faith. As you can see, I think there are merits of running these specific incantation seals if you're mostly running the incantations except for 80 faith. Erdtree peaks at 80, and then its scaling dies down again and turns relatively weaker at 99. You can see that at 70 faith or under, though, all these seals are at least reasonable enough to run if you're mostly main one type of incantation. Let's do a summary to wrap up the video. First, Finger Seal is absolutely garbage, forget it exists. Clawmark Seal can be used for niche strength and faith builds or builds with a lot of strength and little faith. I would usually avoid using the seal though for reasons previously stated. Frenzied Flame Seal is used for the passive or niche builds that are low on faith. Godslayer's Giants and Gravelstone Seals can be used for the specific incantation builds. Godslayer is also the highest faith only scaling seal pre-69 faith. The Erdtree Seal is the highest non-arcane faith scaling seal above 69 faith. This is going to be your go-to if you're playing a main faith build at high levels of faith investment for PvP if you're not running Arcane. Golden Order Seal is mostly for PvEing at higher levels like around 200+, unless you really want to try a Golden Order incantation build with the Sword of Night and Flame in PvP. Finally, the Dragon Communion Seal is absolutely busted with Arcane builds, especially at low levels of investment. If you found the video helpful, please like and subscribe. See you next time.